Hello, guys. In today's episode, it's finally here. Early season goose. On today's episode, an SWO tour. Officially now, goose season here in Ontario, and technically it's getting to the closing end of early season goose, but technically I've been doing a lot of hunting these past few weeks of early season goose, and this year is my actual second year of waterfowl hunting. I have not really got a lot of experience in waterfowl hunting. Like, most of this in the field, like I say in this video, is I'm learning all by myself. I picked a certain lake on public land, this lake that's basically public land, and I was hunting it most of early season goose, and I've been hunting it since opening day. And in this video, you guys are gonna see the most inexperienced waterfowl hunter on the planet, because I can tell you a bit about my hunting history before I get into the video. So technically, when I first started hunting, I first started into the world of hunting white-tailed deer.
When I first started getting into hunting, I pretty much got into deer hunting, and I've done pretty well over my white-tail hunting career. Almost every season I pretty much got a deer, almost every year.
So basically my strong point is hunting deer, because it's a big game animal and that. So I started hunting with rifle and then muzzleloader, and then crossbow. So technically I've gained the experience in the deer hunting world. Then in 2020, my second year of hunting, I got into hunting turkeys. And my first turkey season I was unsuccessful. I was missing birds. And then I gained in 2021, where I shot my first turkey,
which I end up getting this Jake my second season out.
I got shot in May of 2021. And then basically later on that same year, I did a little bit more upland bird hunting and shot my first ruffed grouse,
which I had self-filmed this hunt on a Thanksgiving weekend when I was out grouse hunting.
Dang, like, as long as I've been on YouTube, I've had a short hunting career, basically. And mostly, like, I'm filming the hunts, and I'm taking you guys on the journey as I develop my skills as a sportsman, and a hunter, and everything like that. So, technically, waterfowling was one of the biggest hunts I've wanted to get into for a long time. And, basically, last year I got into it. I bought my first migratory bird license last year. Went out with an 835 shotgun, short-barreled turkey shotgun. Hunted the same public land lake that I'll be hunting in this video, and missed a crap ton of birds. So this is probably the only spot I have available to me to waterfowl hunt, which I'm probably going to look for more spots later on in the season. So technically, this year I wanted to up my game. I bought myself a longer barrel, 28-inch barrel shotgun. Got a bunch of homemade Canadian goose decoys. Built my own homemade blind. And I was determined that this season I was going to drop down some ducks and geese. So, early season goose, you guys are going to see. Will I get the job done? Maybe. Maybe not. So, either ways, let's get on with the video!
Here's the thing we have to do before our hunt begins. First off, a few weeks before season, I decided to get out and do some scouting. So to be ready for early season, I had to get out and do some geese scouting. So we end up finding this lake on public land, the same lake that I hunted the year before. We knew there was tons of geese here, so my preparation plan was to get out and do some scouting a few weeks before season opened up, and it looked like this spot was very promising. There were so many geese that were coming into land, and I had found the perfect spot, but the biggest thing on my mind was where I wanted to set up for this particular hunt. So I had portable blind and everything, decoys and everything else to be ready. So I headed out, checked out this particular spot. We saw a crap ton of geese that flew in. I knew this is where I wanted to be on opening day because there were so many geese here, showing that the promissivity of opening day being successful to me was really much on my mind. So I ended up moving in, trying to get close enough to these birds and trying to figure out a perfect spot to set up my blind. So I end up going out into the lake on the dried part and looking at this big pond where the geese were actually landing. So I had a few options. There were a few covered ridges in this nearby area where I wanted to set up. One was the further weeds that you're looking at in the background there on the left. The other option, there was a ridge right behind me where I wanted to set up as well. Also, I had to get a bunch of decoys ready to go. From the last year's season, my decoys were completely a complete mess, so I had to give them a good cleaning to be ready. So I ended up getting a bunch of dish detergent and just did a bunch of washing of the heads, the full bodies, and everything. So these are all the shell decoys that I got last year. I've got a bunch more decoys ready for this year. I have a crap ton of silhouettes as well that need to be painted and everything, so technically a few days before opening day was my most busiest, getting ready for this early season goose hunt, so I had to do everything in my power to be ready. Now that full of my decoys are now completely cleaned up, I was finally ready to give these birds a nice little rinse, just to be ready for the opening day hunt. So here I am, committing all the footage of cleaning up all the birds from last year's hunting season. So give them a good scrub for the first step, and then my second step was to give them a great and fantastic rinse off, which is what you see right here. Now, I assume, guys, we are ready for the opening day hunt of early season goose 2023.
Hello guys, SW Outdoors. It is currently September 7th, 2023. It is currently like 4:32 in the morning. I'm getting my morning coffee in, which I say morning tea in because I'm out of coffee. And today is Ontario Goose Opener, and we're hunting early season geese. I'm getting all my gear all set up for this morning. All my gear laying out here. I got a bit of my camouflage clothing, my pouch, my bag, my gun sock, some ghillie suit top, and you guys recognize this, my Mossberg Maverick Model 88 12 gauge. It's the first time I'm taking this gun out, and technically I'm using this gun for waterfowl hunting. Pump action. So, long barrel, 28 inch barrel. This gun's gonna kill geese today. I'm predicting, hopefully, if the geese are gonna participate, and if I'm a good shot, this gun will kill geese. The shells I'm running through today is Kent cartridge, fast steel, precision plate steel, and chambered in 3 inch 12 gauge. BB shot. So this is the ammunition we're running through today. So
to kill some birds.
Alright guys, got everything all loaded up in the truck. Got my portable blind, chest waders, some Silhouette decoys, my chair. In the back here, we got all my heavier clothing, my bag, and my 12 gauge that's in the gun stock. So either way, let's get out to the boat launch, get ourselves set up, hopefully stop at Timmy's and grab myself a coffee on the way. So let's see if we can get some luck this morning.
Your forecast is up next. Unhappy with your home heating and cooling system? Thinking about replacing your heat pump system? The Home Comfort...
As we're at the public land right now, I just found out earlier today, my taillight's out in my truck. So I got one working taillight. I'm lucky I got here without getting pulled over. So I think this is a priority to maybe get fixed one of these days, because I'm only working with one taillight. So we got all our stuff in the back, our blind, our decoys, our chest waders. It's not really daylight yet, but we're talking about a little bit of rain this morning. So technically the birds will be probably flying around or whatever, I don't know. They were calling for thunderstorms last night, but we had storms roll through yesterday, so technically we're good for opening day hunt. So we'll set up our blind, we'll get it set up in our position that we were scouting, where we saw those geese a couple weeks ago. So we'll sit in there, hunt there. If I shoot a few geese, I'll be happy. But if we can limit out on 8 birds, because early season we can limit on higher limits, so I'll be happy too. But I'll have a lot to carry out. So either ways, let's get our gear all sorted out. Silhouettes that I made myself that I didn't get enough of them produced and painted. There's one goose out there that doesn't have a side painted, so I painted enough of them just to get them all ready to go for this morning hunt. Well guys, it's starting to drizzle. I think I'm going to pack up for the morning and see what the weather brings this afternoon. If not, we're going to try to get out tomorrow morning, hopefully. But technically, it's raining today, and I think the geese are doing something else today, so they're not really flying around as they should be, so we're packing up. Guys, you're not gonna believe this happened. I had to abandon some of my gear out there because I had so much to carry in this morning. I'm gonna try to find a way, if this afternoon works out, I'm gonna find a way to get a lighter load. Those decoys were a lot to carry, so I had to get my blind back to the truck here, my gun, my chair, backpack, and all that stuff. And I ended up getting freaking figure out where, I kind of lost the spot where I had my decoys. The decoy bag.
lost it for a little bit, and got caught out in the lake during a torrential downpour. Like, look at it right now. It is, like, pouring rain right now, and I am just drenched. Like, drenched today. Happy goose opener, guys. Hope your guys' day is going a lot better than mine. No geese, of course. We didn't shoot anything this morning, so it would have been a lot more carry out of there besides of what I actually had. So either ways, we're heading back home. Alrighty, guys, we are now officially back on the road again. We are heading out a few days later after opener to try to get some geese back down again today, guys. My game plan today is I'm going to use the silhouettes. I'm going to set up my blind in a technical. I'm going to try to find a spot in there to set my blind up and sit there, because I want to try to find a spot that's more concealable and easier. I got a few more decoys I can fit in my backpack, silhouettes. The only reason I'm not taking my other decoys is because it's just too much, like I said, it's too much for me to carry. It's getting to be a little lot for me. And other options, I don't go in with no decoys at all, just a call and my 12 gauge and my blind. But technically, I still got a load of stuff to carry into the public land, and I'm probably going to sit there till dark. But I'm going to try to pack lightly, walk in, and if I do see some geese in that particular pool there, I could probably unload my stuff and go for a little stalk or whatever, try to get the geese and range of my 12 gauge. But my best bet is I'm going to sit there till last legal shooting light and see if the geese will start flying in this afternoon for their evening feed. So I was going to go out this morning, but I just skipped out on this morning and stayed in bed. So technically I'm out this afternoon to try to accomplish it. Ladies and gentlemen, we got a small spread out right there behind us. Hopefully it'll be enough to fool the geese to flying in and checking it out, but I don't know, I got fewer decoys out today. I got a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 decoys out there, homemade, silhouette. I'm not saying it's my best formation I can come up with, but usually we recommend me have a U formation of the geese, but I didn't have a lot of geese to work with, so I just kind of bunch out here, bunch out there, so I might just kind of do one last little bit of spreading out first before I get into my blind. So I got half a dozen of these silhouettes out. I'm going to see tomorrow. Back out tomorrow morning, I can grab some more birds and try out my other formation. I'm going to try to get this silhouette. Anyways, we got another silhouette out. I could have spread this out a little more. We'll try. And if tomorrow doesn't work, we'll try to figure out some way to pack more of those decoys in my bed for another sit. So we got 9 decoys. The Mossberg Maverick is going to get loaded up, and we're heading into the blind.
kind of got it shot back there. Oh boy. Fancy shooting by yours truly. Oh, these geese. Last 2 years, they've been just flying out of range. And like I said, there was another guy that did have been shooting back there. He shot earlier, and after I took my two shots at my gun, at those two geese that were flying past me, and he fired off, I think he fired off one shot or two shots, I think, or three shots, I think. I couldn't remember. I guess you've heard two shots at those geese down there, but that guy has a dog down there, and I've seen him on the way in. I popped off two shots at those birds that came through, and of course, I thought they were going to come back around, so I tried to load my gun quickly as I could. So, technically, yeah, I'm dealing with a sucky situation of doing a lot of fancy missing out here. I don't know about this lake, guys. This lake is just... the geese fly out of range. They don't want to come into the decoys. Where that guy is sitting right now, I might go sit there tomorrow morning and see if I can try to... like, he has no blind or anything like that, so I'm covering up my blind. I might have a lighter carry tomorrow of stuff, or I might not even use decoys tomorrow. I might just walk in here and just set up where I want to set up, because... quite frankly, I don't know if decoys really work in this lake or not, but, yeah. But, we didn't shoot any geese. So, we shot at geese this season, but we haven't hit any. So, either ways, we're doing our best out here. Just wasting ammunition. Guys, I'm making the same mistake as usual. Birds coming in. I kind of hesitated there and took a few shots at a bunch of geese that were flying in. And I'm buggered up my shot. So I don't think my decoys are not really convincing enough, or whatever it is. They're not flying in particularly where I want them. I was very impatient with the shots. So I guess I'm going to be a little bit more patient here with my shots now, if geese are coming in. So, technically, we'll be soon packing up, guys, for the end of legal shooting light. This will be soon, another half an hour. I don't think this spot is really convincing enough where I'm sitting, so we have another game plan set up for this early season hunt. We have tonight, tomorrow, the next day, until the Sunday, until early season closes. So I want to shoot a geese early season, but it's not really working out in my favor right now. So either ways, sun's going down. We'll have a game plan for tomorrow morning when we come back out. So we'll try again. This time we'll start hitting birds. The joys of hunting public land, guys. The joys of hunting public land. Dirt bikers and four-wheelers coming through the lake here. So that's technically my evening hunt. Dirt bikers, four-wheelers coming through. Gotta love public land.
So as you guys can see, early season was just a bit of a bust for me. So I kept missing birds. They weren't flying into my decoys. These geese, I honestly opinionated this lake itself. I don't know if my strategies, my calling abilities, and my shooting capabilities, I'm misjudging the distance of how far the birds are. in the air. So technically, I suck at waterfowling, but I'm trying to get better as I go along on every hunt. So technically, I'm learning as the day goes on of how to hunt these birds. So my goal later on in the season, when double opener, when goose reopens and then duck season opens up, is I'm going to look for more spots to hunt. I'm going to figure out if I can figure out more spots, ask permission on some landowners. I want to try to get some farm real estate to hunt on over fields, over crops. And I want to figure out more public land spots that I could actually hunt too for puddle ducks and diving ducks and so on, so on. So my goal this season is I'm going to do better at waterfowling. I want to get more experience. I'm going to see if I can tag along with more experienced guys and hunt with them to just boost up my experience. So either ways, guys, hope you guys liked the video. I'm sorry I didn't shoot any birds and kept missing. I'm kind of embarrassed from that, but I said I'd take you guys along on the journey. I'm taking you along on. And comment below what I should do different in my tactics. Because either it's my decoy spread, I'm overcalling. I just want to be better at waterfowling, guys. I want to enjoy it. I want to get more into it. I just would like some advice on what I should do different. Because my inexperience as a waterfowler is not really paying off. So, either way, guys, if you guys like the video, make sure you guys put a like. If you're not subscribed to SW Outdoors, make sure you guys click the subscribe button. Click the notification bell when these videos are. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. SW Outdoors. Sign out.